We are now going with one more question of the Advanced Auditing and Assurance Revision Kit from your BPP exam kit for ACCA Associate for Chartered Certified Accountant. My name is Amol. Please do like, subscribe, share and turn on the bell notification. It was question 1 of your revision kit. You are the manager of the Larkin company, responsible for the audit of the heroin company and owner-managed business which operates the chain of the bars and restaurant. This is your firm's first year auditing. The year client and the audit for the year ended 31st March 2002 is underway. The audit senior sends a note of your attention. When I was auditing revenue, I noticed something strange. Heroin's revenue, which is almost entirely cash, is recognized at $4.5 million in the draft financial statement. However, the accounting statement shows that it till receipts for cash paid by the customers amounting to $3.5 million. This seems odd. So I questioned Ava Gul, the finance controller, about this. She said that Jack Heroin, the company's owner, deals with the cash receipts and post journals dealing with the cash and revenue. Ava asked Jack and the reason for these journals, but they refused to give the explanation. When auditing cash, I noticed a payment of $2 million paid by the electronic transfer from the company's bank account to overseas financial institution. The bank statement showed that the transfer was authorized by the Jack Heroin, but no other documentation regarding the transfer was available. Alarmed by the size of the transaction and the lack of the evidence to support it, I questioned Jack Heroin, asking him about the source of the cash receipt and the reasons for electronic transfer. He will not give any answer and become quite aggressive. You are required for discussing the implication of the circumstances described in the auditor's senior's note for 6 marks, and the second part B is you are explain the nature of any reporting that should take place by the audit senior. So I guess that it is clearly mentioned that from the question requirement that it was being recognized at $5.5 million and they have recognized only $3.5 million. So it means, and again it is showing that when they asked the Jack the reason for the journal, but they refused. So this is means that there is a money laundering cases are going on, because they have recognized more when the expenditure amounting just for $3.5 million and they were not giving the explanation. So this means that a money laundering case is here. As you know, in money laundering, there are three stages. First is the placement, followed with the layering and integration. In the first stage, that is the placement, it starts with the first transaction with the investment into the gold, property or so on. In layering, it is a subsequent transaction with multiple transactions happening, and the integration is the point of the satisfaction, which is the maximum transactions has happened, and this way the black money has turned into the white money. As you even know, in the auditor's role in money laundering is they appoint the money laundering reporting officer who receives the information from the partners, assesses the information based on the evidences gathered and passes this information in respect of the money laundering to the regulator. A proper client screening has to be done before accepting the audit. So this is the first case. So you have to be very alert for accepting the new engagements, in which is asked in the question. Again, in a money laundering officer, they should have proper anti-money laundering procedures and proper internal controls system should also be available with a proper working paper documentation for 5 years or more. This information can be provided to the regulators, and in such case a professional skepticism is required, followed with the due care, professional attitude, questioning mind, assessing the evidences and thorough audit. The auditor in case of the money laundering has to be a professional competence in dealing with the client assignment. They should be qualified enough for assigning these assignments. They should have the experience, skills, regular training and the development and a questioning mind and alert, as well as they have to be obtain as much evidences as they can obtain, and they have to observe the client's procedures. So as per the BPP exam kit answers, it has been given the top tips. from where I'm just reading and I'm explaining the things, so that it will be able for you in attempting this question if asked in the exam similar questions. So this question was examined in the connection between the money laundering and the professional skepticism. In part A, you were needed to obtain a understanding about the money laundering which was taking place. If you were sure, then the requirement was containing a little hint by referring to the any reporting that should take place that confirms that the money laundering going on in the scenario. A part A 1 was mainly a matter of explaining what is going on in the scenario. You should be aware of the three stages in the money laundering, such as the placement, layering and the integration, and could house code a well marks by simply applying them in the scenario. But even if you had forgotten what are the stages, you were could still identify then well by just explaining how well each bit of the scenario might be evidence of the money laundering report. Well, the part A was asking about was more about the testing the knowledge, but you should have been able to remember that senior should have the report in the suspicions to the money laundering reporting officer, and that the money laundering reporting officer should decide what to do about the matter. If you explain this well, then you could have got 2 marks out of the 3 without too much effort. So the SCCS examining team's commitments were as follow. In the part A 1, most candidates cover a range of the points and the majority correctly discuss about the fraud and the money laundering. Weaker answers tend to focus on the materiality of the cash transfer to the overseas and seem not to notice the client's suspicious behavior. Candidates are reminded that they will obtain the expected to identify a key issues in questioning scenario, and that in the question of this type, it is important to stop and think about what is happening in the scenario before rushing to the answers. So with this requirement A2, the candidates who were identified the money laundering as an issue and usually scored well here, describing the need to report to the auditors firm, money laundering reporting officer, and what should be reported to them. Weaker answers discuss about the auditor's report or that the fraud money laundering should be reported to the client's management. This is not a good advice when taken from the owner, as the manager was the person acting suspiciously and without having resulted in him being tipped off. And the answers to the part B was reasonably good, with the most candidates were able to attempt an explanation of the term and most identifying poor controls leading to the possible fraud involving in the payroll. To answer part A, implications to the auditor's seniors note, there shall be proper definition of the money laundering followed with the placement, cash-based business, owner's posting transaction, layering, electronic transfer to the overseas, secrecy and aggressive attitude. Audit to be considered very high risk. Senior may be tipped off of the client. Firm may consider the withdrawal from the audit, but this may have tipping off the consequences. And in the part A2, it was about the reporting. So report suspicious immediately to the money laundering reporting officer. Failure to report it itself an offense. Examples of the matters to be reported. Identify of the suspect, etc. Audit senior may discuss the matter with the audit manager, but senior responsible for the report. So as you understood from this question, that there is a money laundering going on in this owner managed, and then you have to also mention about the concealment of the origins of the prices, which leads to the criminal activity, and there is a chances of making the dirty money into the, that is the black money, into the white money by criminal, as it was being generated from the criminal origin. As you can see that it was cash veneration and base recognized at 5.5. However, the accounting system till the receipts for cash to the customers were only 3.5. That is, there is an increase of $2.2 million. So this is a transaction of the money laundering. Again, it is given that there is an electronic transfer of this $2 million from the company's bank account to an overseas financial institution. So this is again that there is a layering for reaching this maximum amount from the placement. to the layering, that is from the bank account of the organization to the overseas financial institution. So this is the case of layering. For turning the black money into the white money, into an economy flow. And this is done in the case of the money laundering for generating and making it further into so much events, so much transactions that it seems like that it's a white money only. And so this is the case of the money laundering. Again, as you can see that there is no segregation of the duty, it is mentioned here. And there was no also other documentation regarding the transfers were available, and they were not giving anything, and they become quite aggressive when the auditor asked. So there is a risk that there is a tipping off is going on, and you had, as an auditor, it should be have a proper understanding, and professional skepticism has to be applied. And in such cases, if such events are happening and there is a restriction on the scope of the audit, then the audit engagement should be withdrawn. Audit firm should also obtain the information and seek legal counsel permission for disclosing this information to the authorities external. However, the legal permission has to be obtained. As the part 2, the auditor senior should report this of the money laundering to the money laundering reporting officer. Money laundering reporting officer is a person responsible for receiving and evaluating the report of the suspected money launderers and make an report to the external bodies. This report will include several things like the name of the suspector, the amount involved in this, the reason for the suspicions, why they feel so, and whether about the money laundered cash. The report must be made available as soon as possible, and it should also make the case. If they are not reporting, then it is not a good thing, and it is an offense. So a reporting should be done by this money laundering reporting officer immediately. There should be no tipping off. There should be proper documentation available, and the senior will be allowed for discussing the suspicion with the audit manager. The auditor should assess himself the suspicion about the reasonable facts and how a proper reporting to the money laundering reporting officer, and they should also alert this money laundering reporting officer as the audit is going on, so that they will be obtaining the much information, and it will be helpful for your Part A of your question 1. In the part B, you are responsible for auditing of the Coote company, and you are currently reviewing the working papers of the audit for the year ended 31 December 2002. In the working paper dealing with the payroll, the audit has commented as follow: several new employees has been added to the company's payroll during the year, with the combined payment of $1,25,000 being made to them. There does not appear to be any authorization for the additions. When I questioned the payroll supervisor who made the amendments, he said that no authorization was needed because the new employees are only working for the company on a temporary basis. However, when discussing with the staffing with the management, it was being stated that no new employee have been taken on this year. On one other than the contest of the controls plan, no other audit work was being performed. You are required, in relation to the audit of the Coote company's payroll, explain the meaning of the term professional skepticism and recommend any further actions that should be taken in the course of the auditor. So the answers will be spread in the following content. You have to understand and define the meaning of the professional skepticism, explain the alert to contradictory evidences, unusual events, fraud indicator. There should be part of the ethical code. Evidence is unreliable and contradictory. Absence of the authorization is fraud indicator. Additional substantive procedures need to be completed. Management comments should be corroborated. Control deficiencies should be reported to the management and to those charged with the corporate governance. Audit junior needs to be better supervision. Training on how to deal with the deficiencies identified should be the flow of your answers for the part B. as it was asking to answer about the term of the professional skepticism, you know that the professional skepticism is the attitude that includes the questioning mind and being alert in the course of the audit in respect to the conditions which are required and that are suspicious or which misstates the or to the errors or the fraud. There should be evidence available in respect of the auditor has to be skeptical and exercise this professional skepticism throughout the work of the audit. So in identifying the possibility of the things which are stated by the management and in real which are not. So there should be proper understanding of this professional skepticism and the proper evidences should be obtained which are reliable. Proper identification of the areas which are error or fraud zone prone. A proper understanding of the audit procedures and a proper tailoring of the audit procedures has to be there. A professional skepticism is very important and it lies in the auditing in every stages. Like you are planning till the reporting stage, that is the completion stage. The further actions which are required by the auditor in this case is to obtain the sufficient appropriate audit evidences, which the auditor thinks they are sufficient and which are enough for explaining the true and fair view. As it is given in the case that several new employees have been added to the company's payroll during the year with the combined payment of $125,000 being made to them. There was no appear to be any authorization for this addition. And when the auditor questioned to the payroll supervisor who made the amendment, she said that there was no authorization being needed as no new employees are being appointed. There should be understanding why there is a difference in both these statements. Secondly, as you may see here that a part-time temporary employees may be appointed and when it was being questioned to the payroll supervisor, they said about the employees. So there should be proper understanding that these employees should also cover the list of the temporary employees. As you may see that there was a payment of $125,000 and there was difference in the opinion. So this can also be a fraudulent place. It can happen that those new employees are fictitious to whom this $125,000 is made. This is a fraudulent activity and it can be the case of your earnings management. And the payroll supervisor and the associate should be informed about this difference and this results to an audit opinion as it is required for this auditor to inform to their managers, to their supervisors and so on. Your part C was in respect to the audit report. You are the manager responsible for the audit of the Nassau Group, which comprises the parent group and the 6 subsidiaries. The audit of all the individual companies' financial statement is almost completed and you are currently carrying out the audit of the consolidated financial statement. One of the subsidiary, Exima, is audited by another audit firm. Your firm has full necessary requirements. In respect to the ISR 600, the consideration the audit of the group financial statement including the work of the combined component auditor and is satisfied to the competence and the independence of the other auditors. You have received from the other auditor the draft auditor's report on the company's financial statement as an extract which is shown below. Your qualified opinion extract. In your opinion, accept the effect for the matters described in the basis of the qualified opinion paragraph. The financial statements give a true and a fair view of the financial position of Exima Company as at 31st March 2002 and an extract of the note 12 Exima has been shown below. So in the note 12, the extract, the company is thus subject to the court case and concern an alleged breach of the planning regulation. The plaintiff is claimed a compensation of $2 million. The management of Exima Company, after seeking the legal advice, believes that there is only 20% chances of the successful claim being made against the company. Figure extracted from the draft financial statement for the year ended 31st March 2002 are as follow. Profit before tax for the Nassau Company and the Exima Company are given along with the total asset. And the basis for the qualified opinion extract, the company is facing financial damage of $2 million in respect of an ongoing court case, more fully explained in the note 12 to the financial statement. As we have seen, the management has not recognized the provision but has disclosed the situation of the contingent liability under the international financial reporting framework. A provision should be made if there is an obligation as a result of the past event, a probable flow and the economic benefit, and a reliable estimate can be made. Audit evidence includes that there is criteria has to be met, and this is our opinion that a provision of $2 million should be recognized according to the net provision of the profit, and the shareholders' equity will have been reduced by $2 million if the provision has not been recognized. An extract of the note 2. So in the requirement, it was being given, it was asked for identifying and explaining the matters that should be considered and actions that should be taken by the group audit management team in forming the opinion on the consolidated financial statement of the group. The part C, the requirement and the answer should be addressing the following. Exuma company is a significant component. We have to check. We also have to look after the materiality level of the individual and the group financial statement. Accounting treatments, the qualification of the Exuma company's financial statement, followed with the review of the audit work performed, consideration of the further audit work, discussed with the group management team and those charged with corporate governance. Request that the Exuma company's management adjust the financial statements. Adjustment should be made on the consolidation and the impact on the group opinion if no adjustment being made. Here we have to identify whether this component is the significant component or not. As you know that if it is contributing more than 50% of the total profit before tax or the total asset, if it's contributing of the group, then it is called a significant component. Here we have to check whether this 20% that is of the group, we have to compare it with the 4 of the Exuma group. So yes, it is a material and it is a significant component, as it is more than the 15% of both the profit before tax and the total assets. Again, there was a audit issue that of the 2 millions they were about the provisions recognition which the auditor fills, and the companies has not recognized the provision but they have looked after this contingent. So it is not a case of the contingent liability and the amount is of 2 million. So we have to compare this of 2 million with both your individual level and the group level. So this 2 millions divided by your 4 of the profit before tax of the Exuma and the total assets 20 of your Exuma, we have to check the materiality level, and also we have to do the same for the Nexau company, which is the group. So not recognizing as the provision, that is the liability, we have to look after and give a qualified opinion, because these percentages are not more than 60%. So an adverse opinion cannot be given. As it is less than 60%, we have to qualify the audit opinion. Since the legal case is going on and it can result that outflow of the resources from the organization if they lose the case. So in such cases, it is also required for the group auditor to discuss with the audit engagement partner of the Exuma company. They have to understand how the case will be and what will be the winning chances, so on. And sometimes if they require, they can also appoint the expert opinion in case of the winning chances separately. It may even happen that if the auditor's expert is not being appointed, they have to look after evidences, appropriate evidences sufficiently, and there should be proper coordination between the both the auditors, or which is of the group auditors as well as the component auditor. They have also checked that since the management has in that they have not recognized the provision, they might be of the opinion that they will be winning the case. So in such cases, based on the management opinion, because the management is the person or the team who knows more about the organization. So in such cases, the qualified opinion which was being given may be revised to give the clean audit opinion, and unmodified opinion. Also, in such cases, a proper information, as the management has not made the provision, they have to inform the management about this requirement of the provision. They have required for the auditors to inform them to the management. Or if the provisions are not made, what will be the impact of this non-making provision on the audit report, as well as the impact on the group auditor's statement, financial statements audited, that is the auditor's opinion on the group, as it is a significant component of the group. And the discussion is important because if the management agrees of making the provision, then they do not have to qualify the audit opinion, because in such cases everything is okay and a clean report has to be issued. A qualified opinion is required if the provisions are not made, but after discussing with the management and if they agrees with the provisioning, then there is no requirement of qualification in the audit opinion, audit report. And suppose if the components management is not agreeing with the provisioning, however, the auditor, if they discuss this with the group level and the group agrees with making the proper adjustment so that there will be no material misstatement, then in such cases, though there will be qualification in the audit report of the component, but there will be no qualification in the audit report of the group, because at the group level everything is done and properly adjustments are made, so there is will be no qualification and clean report will be given. However, since the management of the component haven't agreed, so a qualification is required and at the qualification at the report of the auditors of the group of the component and not of the group, because the group everything is done okay and a proper report has to be given, that is non-qualified clean report. And if the management of both the group as well as the component doesn't agree, then in such cases there will be qualification even at your group level, that is the group auditor's report will also be materially be qualified, so that a proper information is being passed on to the shareholders or to the readers of the auditor's report about this qualification. However, the work of the auditors will not be referred at the group level, because after all it's a component, and at a group level there is no requirement for mentioning the work of the component auditors. So this is all about your question 1 of the LARC, which was P7 June 2012 exams.